heard from our colleague Reema about the state of the telecom sector. We have two gentlemen who join in, Rajan Mathews, the Director General of COAI, and in a bit, Rajiv Sharma, the Co-Head of Research at SBICAP Securities, will also be with us. Gentlemen, thanks so much for joining us. Mr. Mathews, let me start with you. The sector is reeling under 8 lakh crores of debt. We have, you know, bruising price wars, a big dip in revenues. How would you rate the government's performance in the telecom sector? What was the one big hit and the one big miss this time around?
So very clearly, the present government has done a number of things that have contributed, if you will, to the progress of the industry. So I think the whole issue of spectrum sharing, spectrum trading, the right of way, various other duty issues that were ameliorated. So I think the present government has done a number of things that really have addressed the concerns of the industry. I think we have done more damage to ourselves in terms of the bruising telecom war, in terms of tariffs that have gone on. And I think our concerns were more with the regulator than with the government policy making. NDPEC 2018, a fantastic document, done very well. So I think a very positive outcome from the government side so far.
Now, I take your point entirely, Mr. Mathews. You actually set the stage. Maybe the government had little to do in telecom in terms of rule making. It is the regulator and it is the market. And to be fair, they inherited a weak sector. I mean, your 8 lakh crore of, or 7 lakh crore, I think, of debt was also not something which was the creation of only the last few years, though competition has wearied everybody. Your take, do you think policy could have been different and helped the sector in the last 5 years?
Well, I would just echo what Rajan said, that you know, this 2018 NTP has been clearly landmark. It's talking about amending the Telegraph Act. It's talking about fiber, and first time there have been some specific goals around fiber of towers, fiberization of towers and all. So very well set on that. And if you look at the data subscribers, we've gone up from 60 million data subs to 500 million, of which 400 are 4G. So that's been a significant achievement. It's only that your revenue CAGR in the last 5 years has been down by double digit because you added a lot of subs, and also how the industry played out. The players played out, not so the policy.
Okay. Mr. Mathews, you'll have to admit that the ecosystem of Digital India should have helped players a lot.
So very clearly, yes, that is one of the bright spots in the industry in terms of clearly Jio coming in, establishing the fact that 4G is now the dominant technology. 2G is dead, 3G is dead, there's a transition to 4G, and now clearly highlighting the country's need to move over to 5G. So I think all of those is the right direction. I think one of the areas that we've been working with the government is this one, addressing the high debt load that you talked about, that came from what we would call the anomalous pricing of spectrum and the limited amount of spectrum that was put up for auction. So I think that created the debt burden. And the point we're saying is that stop double taxing us. In the old regime, before the auction process of spectrum, you had revenue share. When auction process started and you started paying for spectrum upfront, you should have removed the legacy revenue share. Unfortunately, the industry is saddled with both. So you have the upfront payments for spectrum, the continuing extraction of revenue through revenue share. And so now over 30% of every rupee that comes to the industry goes back to the government. And I think that is one area that the government could clearly address to get the industry back on its feet.
Okay. Rajiv, you know, I wanted to discuss this interconnect user charge, that big slashing of the charge that the TRAI did. Do you think it benefited Jio in one way? And do you think it was fair at all?
Well, this is something which happens globally. Internet is always on a, you know, a decline path. So one can, you know, debate on the timing, but that's a natural course. Yes, it was supposed to happen a couple of years later. It happened a little before. But, you know, what we have also achieved is a huge data subs growth and the path from 4G to 5G. Yes. So that's been there. And to the point, you know, Rajan said that it's all going to now about spectrum pricing. Mm. So ROE of Bharti in 2009 was 30%. Now it's low single digits. So you have to get the spectrum pricing correct. You cannot have spectrum which is priced 15 times versus Korea, and your data tariffs at the lowest in the world. So that has to change.
Yeah, absolutely. For a digital India, you just have to price spectrum more correctly. Well, one final word, Rajan. What's the message to the next government? Charges, I guess.
So I think the message to the next government is very clear. You folks have done an excellent job of putting the policy document together, which is the NDPC 2018 document. So in the next 6 to 9 months after the new government comes in, begin to start implementing what has been articulated so very clearly and well. One is this whole issue of removing this debt overhang, fixing this double taxation issue, fixing the right-of-way issues, making sure that fiberization can happen. If we can address these critical issues, I think the industry will be well on its way to recuperation.
Okay. Rajan and Rajiv, thank you very much for joining us and giving us the benefit of your observations. So clearly, government gets minus marks for the very high spectrum charges and what Rajan calls double taxation of the industry. One hopes that the next government is able to at least correct the debt load.